Hello all. So now in this section of pharmacology series, we will be discussing about the rapid MCQ revision of arthritis. So here we will be discussing about the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. And we will also be discussing about the treatment of gout. So these two topics are very important and questions comes very oftenly from these topics. So let's start with first rheumatoid arthritis. Let's discuss first certain basics. The which drug to be used in which cases of rheumatoid arthritis. So if you talk about rheumatoid arthritis, it is an autoimmune condition in which the synovial joints antibodies are formed against synovial joints. Now if a patient of rheumatoid arthritis comes, what is the treatment? Our main treatment first is to control the acute attack or the flare up. For this we give symptomatic treatment. We control the inflammation by giving non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug NSAIDs, given in red, and they offer only symptomatic relief. Okay, in resistant cases we can give corticosteroid, they also provide symptomatic relief. Now in the long term we have to retard the joint destruction or slow the joint destruction, hence we have to reduce immunity of the body, hence we give immunosuppressive drug. They are known as DMARDs or SARD. DMARDs or SARD are known as disease modifying anti-rheumatic drug or slowly acting anti-rheumatic drug. They cannot be given in acute attack because they are very slowly acting. Their action comes after many months. And corticosteroid can also retard joint destruction. Hence, corticosteroid have both action. They are given for acute attack also, for retarding the joint destruction also. Now the point is, this corticosteroid should not be given in long-term basis because it may lead to Cushing syndrome. Hence, in long-term treatment, we give DMARDs, that is disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drug. So what are the different DMARDs? This is the complete list of DMARDs. We have the older DMARDs, which decrease the level of lymphocyte in our body, like methotrexate, which is an anti-folate compound. It inhibits folic acid, hence lymphocyte will not develop. Methotrexate also causes adenosine efflux, which also suppresses lymphocytic count. We have leflunomide. It inhibits pyrimidine synthesis by blocking dihydroorotase dehydrogenase enzyme. We have azathioprine enzyme, which inhibits HGPRTS. We have cyclosporin, which is a calcineurin inhibitors. We have an anti-malarial drug, chloroquine, hydroxychloroquine, rarely nowadays used because it can lead to bullseye or bullseye maculopathy or bullseye retinopathy. Then we have a drug, sulfasalazine, which is a prodrug with two active molecules. One active molecule is known as sulfapyridine, which is effective in rheumatoid arthritis. And second active molecule of sulfasalazine is 5-aminosalicylic acid, used in the treatment of ulcerative colitis. Then the older drugs, gold and D-penicillamine. D-penicillamine is a chelator also. Nowadays, they are rarely used because they are very toxic drug. They cause diarrhea, dermatitis, dyscrasia of bloods. That we will discuss. Everything is discussed in video series. Then we have targeted therapy. Now, targeted therapy is also known as biologics. We will target the inflammatory molecule and we will remove that inflammatory cytokines. So we have TNF-alpha inhibitor known as IKH, infliximab, sertolizumab, adalimumab, golimumab, etanercept. They have other uses as well. Interleukin-1 inhibitor, anakinra, interleukin-6 inhibitor, tocilizumab, sarilumab, JAK1 and 3 inhibitor, tofacitinib. Recently, we have a new JAK1 and 2 inhibitor. JAK stands for Janus kinase, that is baricitinib. Then we have CD20 inhibitor, rituximab, and co-stimulation inhibitor, abatacept. So this is the complete list of the drugs which are used in rheumatoid arthritis. Keeping this thing in mind, let's solve the questions of rheumatoid arthritis. A drug which is effective in rheumatoid arthritis but not appropriate for osteoarthritis. The answer for this question number is infliximab. Now the point is, what about A, B, C and D? Remember, these drugs are NSAIDs, and NSAIDs, they are given for acute attack of any type of arthritis. Acute attack of any arthritis, whether it is rheumatoid arthritis, gouty arthritis or psoriatic arthritis. Now what is infliximab? We will write infliximab. Mab word is coming. It's a monoclonal antibody that block TNF-alpha. And what are the uses? We will write a mnemonic, WAPSI. It is given in Wegener's granulomatosis. It's a granulomatous condition. It is given in arthritis. Which arthritis? Only and only rheumatoid arthritis and psoriatic arthritis. because these two conditions are autoimmune disease due to high level of TNF-alpha, but not in osteoarthritis. The reason is osteoarthritis is rather an aging process. It is not an autoimmune condition. It is also given in sarcoidosis, and it is given in inflammatory bowel disease like ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. So these are the uses of infliximab that you must remember. The next question is asking, a 45-year-old male is presented to OPD with severe pain in the knee and shoulder joint. On examination and further investigation, a diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis is made. He started on methotrexate. After using methotrexate, still arthritis continued. Physician want to add another DMARD that inhibit pyrimidine synthesis by inhibiting dihydroorotase dehydrogenase. The answer for this question is leflunomide. So leflunomide is pyrimidine synthesis inhibitor which inhibit dihydroorotate dehydrogenase enzyme, and it is a hepatotoxic drug just like methotrexate, and it requires a loading dose of 100 milligram when we start it. Okay, now which of the following disease modifying anti-rheumatic drug is a prodrug? The answer is sulfasalazine. Now sulfasalazine has two active metabolites. One is 5-aminosalicylic acid, which is given in the treatment of ulcerative colitis, and sulfapyridine, which is effective in the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. So it's one drug with two uses, because itself is an inactive drug. The bacteria present in intestine breaks down into two active metabolites, 5-ASA and sulfapyridine. Which of the following is a DMARD? We have already discussed a copper chelator. Penicillamine is a DMARD, while desferoxamine, which is an iron chelator, succimer, dimer, caprol, they are not used in rheumatoid arthritis. It is penicillamine, because penicillamine is also a copper chelator. It is also given in Wilson's disease. Okay. Now, which of the following disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drug is the drug of first choice? Remember, the drug of choice for rheumatoid arthritis is methotrexate. Methotrexate is considered as a drug of choice because it is the most effective drug for rheumatoid arthritis. The most common toxic reaction of gold therapy. Remember, the most common reaction of gold therapy is dermatitis. Second, it also causes diarrhea, stomatitis, or GIT disturbance. It also causes dyscrasia of blood. Dyscrasia of blood, that means hemolytic anemia. It also causes drug-induced SLE, and it is also nephrotoxic. So these are the side effects of gold therapy, and the answer for this question number is dermatitis and stomatitis. Okay. Now, a drug X is useful in the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. It is only available in parenteral formulation, and the mechanism of action is TNF-alpha inhibitor. The drug is, the answer is etanercept. We have already discussed TNF-alpha inhibitors. The mnemonic was ICAGE. I for infliximab, cetuximab, adalimumab, golimumab, and etarnicept. So these are the drugs which are TNF-alpha inhibitor. Remember the mnemonic ICAGE. And among them, infliximab is given IV. Rest all other drugs are given by subcutaneous injection. And what about the side effect? These drugs, they cause reactivation of TB and HBV virus. And their side effect is they themselves can cause SLE reactions. So this is all about, and we have already discussed the uses of infliximab, a mnemonic WAPSI, in the earlier part. Okay. Now let's talk about gout. Now what is gout? If you talk about gout, gout is a symptom, constellation of symptoms, which occurs due to deposition of uric acid in various tissues. It occurs due to deposition of uric acid. Suppose this uric acid is deposited in joint, it will lead to gouty arthritis. If it gets deposited in tendons, ligaments, and soft tissue, it can lead to tophi. If it is excreted out through kidney, it can lead to urine. In urine, it may produce uric acid stones, etc. Now let's see what is the treatment of gout. So if you talk about the treatment of gout and rheumatoid arthritis is somewhat same. If a patient for acute attack of gout will come, what we will give? We will control the inflammation. Hence, we give anti-inflammatory drug. The drug of choice for acute attack of gout is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. But we don't give aspirin. Aspirin is not given because aspirin increases uric acid level. If it is not responsive, we give colchicine. Remember, colchicine and NSAID, they are given for both treatment and long-term prevention of gout. If there is still resistance, we can give corticosteroid, but corticosteroid are only given in acute attack of gout. Long-term treatment, we don't give corticosteroid because they cause Cushing syndrome. Now, what about chronic gout? The chronic gout treatment is, we have to reduce uric acid level in the blood of the patient in long term, so that this uric acid should not get deposited. And for reducing the level of uric acid in blood, we have three kinds of drug: xanthine oxidase inhibitor, uric acid oxidase enzyme, and uricose uric agent. So let's talk about these drugs for chronic gout. The drugs for chronic gout, let's see how gout occurs. Suppose, let's start from the beginning. There is a molecule known as xanthine. Xanthine is a purine. This xanthine goes to the liver, and there is an enzyme, xanthine oxidase, which converts it into uric acid. Uric acid comes out into the blood. So we have a drug which inhibits the synthesis of uric acid known as xanthine oxidase inhibitor. So these drugs are known as xanthine oxidase inhibitor. Drugs are allopurinol, its active form oxypurinol, and febuxostat. Exo means xanthine oxidase, stat means inhibitor. Then we have a drug, uric acid oxidase, which converts uric acid into a water-soluble molecule, allantoin. So, rusfuricase and pegloticase, allantoin cannot deposit it in tissue. It is excreted out in urine. Then, when uric acid is excreted out in kidney, it can reabsorb back into the blood by NN transporter known as OATP transporter. Then we have OATP inhibitor. These drugs, they inhibit the reabsorption of uric acid back into the blood. These drugs are known as uricose uric agent, because they will excrete uric acid into the urine. The drugs are probenecid, benzbromarone, sulfenpyrazone, a new drug lesinurad, and losartan and fenofibrate also have. Losartan is an antihypertensive drug. Fenofibrate is a hypolipidemic drug. They also have uricose uric property. So this is the drugs, the summary of gout. Let's talk about now the questions related to gout. Now, the best drug for chronic gout patient is allopurinol. Allopurinol is considered as a drug of choice for gout. Okay, so in chronic gout. But if the question comes acute gout, remember in acute gout, we give NSAIDs like naproxen. Okay, probenecid and sulfenpyrazone, they are uricose uric agent. They are given as an add-on drug. And the drug of choice is xanthine oxidase inhibitor, allopurinol. And it is safe in renal failure because it acts at a level of liver. Probenecid and sulfenpyrazone, they are contraindicated in renal failure. Okay. NSAID is only given in acute gout, not in chronic gout. Allopurinol works on the basis of, we have discussed that allopurinol inhibits the synthesis of uric acid by inhibiting xanthine oxidase. Hence, the answer is it decreases the synthesis of uric acid. Allopurinol. Uricose uric agent among all of the following is, the answer is probenecid. Okay, probenecid. All of the following drugs can produce hyperuricemia except, the answer is sulfenpyrazone. Sulfenpyrazone rather causes decrease in uric acid, removal of uric acid into the urine. Now remember, two anti-tubercular drug which can cause gout are pyrazinamide and ethambutol. But remember, pyrazinamide causes more gout as compared to ethambutol. And remember, loop and thiazides, diuretics, they can also cause gout. Okay, so these are the causes of drug induced gout. So you have to remember this part. Now, most common dose limiting adverse effect of colchicine is, now what is colchicine? Colchicine is given in acute treatment and prevention of gout. Colchicine is a microtubule inhibitor. Hence, it inhibits, microtubule is needed for migration of WBC. It inhibits migration of WBC. And it is the most effective drug for acute attack of gout. It is the most effective drug for acute gout. But what is the side effect of colchicine? The most common side effect of colchicine is it causes GIT disturbance. It causes diarrhea. This is the most common side effect of colchicine. And the good thing about colchicine is it is kidney safe. It is safe in renal failure because gout commonly occurs in renal failure. So the question is diarrhea. Okay. So the most common dose limiting side effect of colchicine is diarrhea. So it inhibits the migration of WBC, an important question also. Now allopurinol is given in, now let's come to question number 6. Now allopurinol is given, is useful in all of the following except. Now allopurinol, remember, is a xanthine oxidase inhibitor. It inhibits the conversion of xanthine into uric acid. It inhibits the conversion of xanthine into uric acid. Now where it is used, we will write a mnemonic, CULT D. The uses of allopurinol is, it is given in chronic gout. But remember, allopurinol is contraindicated in acute gout because in acute gout, we don't reduce the level of uric acid. It is also given in urate nephropathy or uric acid stone. It is given, it is the drug of choice for Lesch-Nyhan syndrome. It is also given in tumor lysis syndrome. Tumor lysis syndrome. And it is given in tumor lysis. And it is given for diuretic induced gout. We know that diuretics, they may cause gout or hyperuricemia. So these are the uses of allopurinol. Okay. But if you remember, allopurinol now is used to reduce uric acid level, but allopurinol was developed. It was developed for the treatment of one protozoa known as Kala Azar. Although it is now not used for Kala Azar or Leishmania infection, but it was developed as a drug for Kala Azar. So keeping this thing in mind, let's see the treatment of what is the answer. The first is cancer chemotherapy induced hyperuricemia, true. This is known as tumor lysis syndrome. Next is diuretic induced hyperuricemia, true. Hydrochlorothiazide is a diuretic. Kala Azar, true. But it is not given in acute gout. Remember, allopurinol is contraindicated in acute gout because in acute gout, we don't reduce the level of uric acid. Uric acid itself is an anti-inflammatory molecule. Allopurinol inhibits the conversion of xanthine into uric acid, that we already know. Drug of choice for acute gout is NSAIDs. And try to find an NSAID, that is indomethacin. Which of the following drug is useful in chronic gout, but it is not a uricose uric agent? The answer is allopurinol. Okay, so allopurinol is not a uricose uric agent and it is used in chronic gout. Probenecid and sulfenpyrazone are uricose uric agent. Phenylbutazone is an NSAID. Ruspuricase, it is a uric acid oxidase. It is a uric acid oxidase which converts uric acid into allantoin. And allantoin is a water soluble molecule. Hence, it increases the urate oxidation into allantoin. So the answer is B. Answer is B. Which of the following increases uric acid excretion? Uric acid excretion means uricose uric action. We have already discussed that lesinurad is a new drug with a uricose uric action. Allopurinol potentiate the effect of. Now we know that allopurinol is a xanthine oxidase inhibitor. Now remember, there are two drugs. One is 6-mercaptopurine and azathioprine. 6-mercaptopurine and azathioprine in the body, they are degraded by xanthine oxidase enzyme. And allopurinol, it inhibits xanthine oxidase enzyme. Hence, the toxicity or the effect of allopurinol, 6-mercaptopurine and azathioprine will increase. Hence, toxicity may come. Hence, if you are combining allopurinol with 6-mercaptopurine or azathioprine, reduce their dose by 75%. So if you are giving 100 milligram, now give the dose as 25 milligram. Hence answer is mercaptopurine. Because these drugs are degraded by xanthine oxidase, allopurinol inhibits xanthine oxidase. Drug useful for gout, we know is allopurinol. A 30-year-old male present with OPD with sudden onset of swelling and redness in left metatarsophalangeal joint. Remember, the most common site of gout is metatarsophalangeal joint, first metatarso. This is the most common joint involved in gout. A needle aspirate of joint shows negatively bifringent crystals. Now remember, the crystals of uric acid is bifringent type. Okay. The physician prescribed a drug for a patient, but he came back next day with nausea, vomiting and diarrhea. After taking the medication, the most likely drug, I told you the most common side effect of colchicine was diarrhea. Why we are marking the answer colchicine? The first reason is colchicine, the most common side effect is diarrhea, and colchicine is given for acute attack of gout. It is given for acute attack of gout. Now the point is, allopurinol is not given in acute gout. Steroids, they don't cause nausea and diarrhea. Steroids are rather anti-emetic drug. They rather suppress diarrhea. Okay. So remember, indomethacin is an NSAID. Okay. Indomethacin is an NSAID. Okay. Now, which of the following drugs is useful in acute attack of gout? We know in acute attack of gout, NSAIDs are used. Not controlled, colchicine is used. Not controlled, corticosteroids are used. Okay. So try to find an NSAID. The answer is piroxicam. Piroxicam is an NSAID, longest acting NSAID. Allopurinol and sulfenpyrazone, they are used in chronic gout. Furosemide is a diuretic. It itself causes gout. Probenecid is an OATP inhibitor. Probenecid interacts with. Now probenecid is an OATP inhibitor. OATP is a transporter in kidney. Suppose this is the kidney. And this transporter is responsible for removal of blood, removal of substance into the urine and blood. It's a bi-directional transporter. Now remember, in our urine, there is uric acid. Uric acid comes back into the blood by OATP transporter. And penicillins, they come into the urine by OATP transporter, organic anion transporter protein. Hence, probenecid inhibits this transporter. So it's a bi-directional transporter, probenecid inhibit. Because of this reason, uric acid will be removed out in urine. Hence, probenecid is a uricose uric agent. It promotes the excretion of uric acid into the urine. Uric acid level in the blood will reduce. Second, it will increase the blood level of penicillins. Hence, it will boost the effect of penicillin. All penicillin, they end with the word cillin. Try to find the answer, ampicillin. So ampicillin is a type of penicillin. Okay. Now prolonged allopurinol therapy in a patient of gout is not indicated for tophi, it is indicated. Urate nephropathy, indicated. Evidence of Boynton joint, indicated. Remember, allopurinol is not effective in acute gout. We have already discussed. In acute gout, we don't give allopurinol. Allopurinol is only given in chronic gout. So this is all about autocoits and gout. So for the complete concept, you can log into the videos. You can see the videos. So this is the only the rapid revision series. So thank you very much.